them. And thank you all for being patient. Our honored guests, both of them just arrived, just in time, for this big birthday party, actually. And McCall, it's not your birthday party, even though it is his birthday today. My son's up there. This is truly a birthday party. And I like to say this, when the company comes here in Spartanburg, because we're all celebrating the birth today. And we're not just interested in just birthing this baby, but we want to see this baby grow and succeed and then expand and do everything that they initially thought was right in having the birth of the baby right here in Spartanburg County. On behalf of Spartanburg County Council, the Economic Futures Group, I want to welcome you to this afternoon's press conference and this exciting announcement. And I really would like to thank each and every one of y'all for coming this afternoon. Thank you for taking your time to be here with us, because you're all VIPs, every one of you, as well as all 285,000 people in Spartanburg County. In Spartanburg, South Carolina, we are revolutionary. And as you look around the room, we're also soaring. What a beautiful facility we're in. And I want to thank President Jennifer Evans of the Chapman Cultural Center for allowing us to host this party here today. I called Jennifer last Friday evening and said, Jennifer, we need a place to host the celebration. Without hesitation, she said, let's do it right here. And what better place to do it, because not only is the cultural center soaring, but so is Spartanburg. So thank you, Jennifer, and your team. Today, our lives revolve around our rich cultural offerings, our extensive educational opportunities. I think Mayor Barnett called it College Town at one time, with all the universities that we have, the community college, our great high school and undergraduate and underschool programs that we have. Look at our musical heritage, the Marshall Tucker Band, to speak of a lot of others too. Go Sam, you're right. Our racing legacy. Just recently, we lost one of them, the late Cotton Owens. Bud Moore is still around, and David Pearson. Our food. I mean, we're not far from, Jeff, it's a driver. You could almost hit the beacon from here. You know, we got the sugar and spice. Facilities have been around since the 50s. Ice. And all the new facilities we have now. Cribb's Kitchen, which Mike and I enjoyed, along with Carter Smith, just a few weeks ago. Our love of the outdoors. Someone told me recently that there are more hunting and fishing licenses per capita right here in Spartanburg County in the upstate of South Carolina than anywhere else in the country per capita. And also just our simple abundance of a stunning landscape. I mean, look at that sky out there. Not a cloud in the sky today. Yesterday was a different story. You walk outside, you can see the mountains right here. We're at the crossroads of all that is dynamic about the modern South. And you think about it, the crossroads, we've said this many, many times. New York City, 800 miles away. Miami, Florida, 800 miles away. We are really at the crossroads. And I am a history fan, so I got to do a little educating for just a minute. Because so many people, I think, in this room, not everybody's from Spartanburg. I'm not from Spartanburg. I moved here by way of Wofford. But so many people don't know a little history about the site we're going to talk about. In fact, I told Mike about it the first time we met. It's called the Armitage Site. And it's called that for a reason. The Armitage Site was owned by Mr. Milliken. And Dr. Norman Armitage was a dear friend of his who worked with Milliken. Dr. Armitage was a chemical engineer as well as a lawyer. And he worked with the Milliken Group for a long time. But what's interesting about him, and I remember hearing this story from his wife, Constance Armitage, who later became Miss Antonson. But Dr. Armitage participated in six Olympics from 1928 to 1956. And if you look on the record, if you Google it right now, the number of Americans who participated in more Olympics, there's only one person, and that person happens to be an equestrian. And not only did Dr. Armitage participate in the Olympics, he won a bronze medal in the 1948 Olympics in London in the Sabre event. Miss Armitage, many of y'all know, and And I know both of them are looking down now from heaven, smiling, especially on their facility and what it's going to become and that piece of property. But Ms. Armitage taught fencing here up until her late 80s. She was a dear friend and a mentor of mine. In fact, she was my co-chairman on every one of my campaigns. But a great lady. So I mentioned this to Mike when we first talked about it, and it impressed me with what he said that they would do in honor of that legacy. We are Spartanburg, and we are revolutionary. Carter Smith, where's Carter? Yes, Carter. Jeff Horton, our chairman of county council. We've worked for over 20 years together to try to make Spartanburg the place that we would all want our children to come back and live and raise their families and have an opportunity. We've tried to make it a land of opportunity and bring companies here that afforded these opportunities to all the people of Spartanburg and really make it a quality of life place. Well, we've been blessed more than we should have in the last 20 years. You know, $14 billion invested in Spartanburg County, 40,000 jobs, and just look at this year. In February, Toray Industries, the finest carbon fiber company in the world, coming to Spartanburg. Then last month, BMW, you know, cements their decision 22 years ago to come here, investing another large amount. And today, when you hear what we're doing, this is a triple crown. This is the triple crown. In fact, this announcement today is one of the most exciting that I've ever been involved with when it comes to economic development. Because so often, you know, people will say, you know, this company announcement, that's great. The rising tide does float all boats, and it helps all of us. But this announcement today, not only will all 285,000 people in Spartanburg have an opportunity to enjoy and to experience, but so will Lawrence County, Union County, Cherokee County, Greenville County, Anderson County, Oconee, and then you're going to move just west of Charlotte. We'll bring in lots of people from North Carolina, lots of people from Tennessee, and lots of people from eastern Georgia. This is going to be a facility that will bring people here that will be able to experience the southern hospitality that Spartanburg really does offer. Let me make a quick comment, too, because I'm going to say something about it in just a second. When I mentioned the Toray officials, when they were here a few months ago, they independently, on their own, the two top executives, came down into downtown Spartanburg, had dinner, walked around, went out in the county, and the thing that made it so important to them, that helped them make their decision, was the hospitality of everybody here. Nobody knew who they were. Nobody had a clue who these two gentlemen were, but they were shown something that we know about. We not only make the finest products in the world, make the finest car, finest carbon fiber, and thousands of other things right here, but we make people feel special. And that's what it's all about. That's why we love Spartanburg, and that's why I know this will be such a huge, huge success. 20 years ago, 22 years ago, the BMW executives did the exact same thing. And I think Mike, when you and Stacy, when we had dinner together, you saw that hospitality and that love. They didn't know who the two were, but the waitresses and the staff at Cribb's Kitchen showed them what we're all about. Well, I want to thank a couple folks and a couple groups real quickly, then we're going to get on to the big announcement. I'd like to thank the citizens of Spartanburg, like I said, for supporting us and showing people around the world what we do and do right. We treat other people with kindness, with support, and we know what it's all about. Also, I want to thank all 285,000 people in Spartanburg for being behind us. I'd also like to thank Spartanburg County. Our county is blessed with an unbelievable staff, led by our administrator, Catherine O'Neill, and the team. We have a lot of them out here. Every day they go beyond the call of duty to do their job because they know everybody's watching. And we get complimented so often in our council meetings. Catherine does this thing and recognizes people from letters that people send in. So I want to thank the staff for making us who we are. And I got to speak to a couple individuals here. Jeff Horton, our chairman. I say Jeff and I have worked together for 20 years. Jeff, I thank you for giving me the opportunity to serve as chairman of economic development. And like I said, about a month and a half ago, thank you all, six other council members, for giving me the freedom to go out and work with these companies, because a lot of what we do is solo and independent. Dale Colbert, Roger Nutt, Michael Brown, Jane Hall, and O'Neill Mintz, that's the rest of the team. I've never worked with a council that's more committed to economic development and supporting our companies without hesitation, so I thank you. Also, Catherine O'Neill, Jim Hill, Lisa Claxton, Debbie Ziegler, John Harris, Jenny DuPont, Jim Campbell, and Jim, thanks for the kayaks and canoes over here, and the best sheriff in the state of South Carolina, probably in the country, Sheriff Chuck Wright. I told Mike when I first met him, I said, what do you mean, Sheriff Wright? If these council members aren't all about what you do, that man right there is. He's all about law and order, too. So thank you, Sheriff, for what you do for this county. Also want to thank our partners at the state, Governor Nikki Haley and her team, the PRT group. Thank them for their support in helping making this project come to life. And again, if any of y'all were here at the Tory announcement, I couldn't say enough about Packlet Milliken, led by John Montgomery, Stuart Winslow, and Jennifer Calabrero. I mean, these banners, first of all, these banners don't get hung and made by themselves. Stuart, he's incredible. You are an incredible asset in Spartanburg County, not just in doing this stuff, but such a great ambassador, as is John and the whole Rick Webble, the whole Packlet Milliken team. We're just so fortunate to have them as our partners. And again, Mr. Milliken, I know you're looking down from heaven too. Yeah, thank you for putting this team together. Our Economic Futures Group, led by Russ Weber, our chairman. Russ does a great job, not only in his volunteer work as chairman of the Economic Futures Group, but as a key business leader in Spartanburg with one of the QS1 parent companies. But Carter Smith, Brian Nash, and Royal Comer, there she is. Thank you all for all that y'all have done too. Royal's here at lunch, we're all hanging these banners, getting this stuff done. But all the time they're working with the media to get the word out of what we're doing and working with the investor group. Thank you all. And I want to say a special word of thanks too for a gentleman that's in the audience who's been a mentor to me for over 40 years. Knew him, met him when I first came to Spartanburg, and he really has not only helped me, but he's helped Spartanburg beyond, you know, what any of us will ever know. That's former Mayor Bill Barnett, a true leader who helped set this county and this city on the soaring path that we're on. I've tried to get him to run for governor. I've tried to get him to run for president. He can do president in his sleep. But thank you, Bill, for all that you do and what you've done for downtown Spartanburg. Just an incredible asset. Thank you. You know, 200 years ago, or nearly 240 years ago, there was a shot that was heard around the world in Concord, Massachusetts. Wasn't long after that we assembled our own team right here in Spartanburg called the Spartan Regiment, who did likewise. I mean, they helped put us on the path that we now enjoy, America. The Spartan Regiment did a great job. You know, Daniel Morgan's statues, again, Jeff hits the driver about that far, right over across the way. But again, I gotta give thanks too for Jane Hall and Mayor Harris and Chris Jennings. They're the ones that really came up with this Spartanburg's revolutionary. It ties right into our heritage and what we're all about. And today's announcement will be heard around the world, trust me. Thanks a lot in part to the media and social media. We've got friends in Germany, France, Japan, China, and the list goes on. In fact, Spartanburg County has more foreign-owned business right here in Spartanburg than anywhere else in the country per capita. They will be listening tomorrow morning and reading about this great announcement, because it will impact every one of them as they move their associates here and they come to visit. The things that will be attached to this announcement today, they will enjoy. So let's do it. Let's unveil the big catch. great American story, Bass Pro Shops is a great American story. John Morris, and what he's done in such a short amount of time is incredible. You know, from its humble beginnings, Bass Pro Shops has revolutionized the outdoor retail experience. And how fitting that it is now part of our revolutionary journey to change the course of our history here in Spartanburg. I'm going to read this press release before I introduce our man. And this gentleman, Mike Dunham, has become a very good friend of mine in a very short amount of time since last October. But let me read this. Bass Pro Shops to open new mega outdoor store in Spartanburg County, South Carolina. The store, Bass Pro Shops, third in South Carolina, will be over 120,000 square feet, two football fields, and will feature the company's popular Uncle Buck's Fishbowl and Grill. Spartanburg County, South Carolina, byline. Bass Pro Shops, an outdoor retailer specializing in hunting, fishing, camping, and other related outdoor gear, is proud to announce plans for a new store in Spartanburg County, South Carolina. The Bass Pro Shops retail attraction will be located between Greenville and Spartanburg on Interstate I-85 at Highway 101. It will be the primary anchor for a 75-acre mixed-use development that will include hotels, retail, and restaurants. The new Bass Pro Shops Outdoor World store is slated to open in 2016. This will be the company's third store in South Carolina, as they currently operate a store in Myrtle Beach, while a store in North Charleston was recently announced. Quote, "We are very excited to have the opportunity to build a super outdoor store directly fronting I-85 near Greer. We're proud to offer Bass Pro Shops low prices and famous friendly expert services to the many sportsmen and women who call this region home," said Johnny Morris, founder of Bass Pro Shops. "This store will be a tribute to the great sporting tradition and heritage of the region and a celebration of the sporting men and women of South Carolina. Located in the rustic beauty of the Cherokee foothills of South Carolina's upcountry region, Spartanburg County has a colorful past. The area was a major hunting ground for the local Cherokees and is steeped in history from the Revolutionary War to the arrival of the railroad. Today, more than 1 million people live in the greater Greenville-Spartanburg-Anderson combined statistical area. Spartanburg County includes several outdoor recreational areas, including Cross State Park, the Packlet, Ennery, and Tiger Rivers, in addition to being located on the Cherokee Foothill Scenic Highway. More than 80,000 vehicles will pass by the new Spartanburg County Bass Pro Shops Outdoor World each day en route to the area's many outdoor opportunities." This is my quote. "We're extremely excited that Bass Pro Shops will be developing a significant outdoor-oriented retail center in Spartanburg County," said David Britt, County Councilman for Spartanburg County. "Bass Pro Shops being recognized as one of America's premier outdoor retailers for their commitment to offering unique shopping experiences will greatly enhance the shopping opportunities for not only in Spartanburg, but also in the upstate and adjoining states. We are confident that this outdoor retail center will have a positive impact on our hospitality and tourism industry. Nationally, Bass Pro Shops will host more than 116 million people visiting their 85 stores and marine centers across America and Canada this year. The average customer stays 2.5 hours. They didn't know about O'Neill and Dale and Jeff and everybody else in this room. We stay a lot longer. But and drives an average distance of over 50 miles. Bass Pro Shops was named by Advertising Age magazine as one of the top 10 hottest brands in America, along with name brands such as Old Spice, M&M's, iPad, and Droid. Also, Bass Pro Shops has been recognized numerous times for their conservation and outdoor education efforts, as well as being recognized by J.D. Powers and Associates for their customer service excellence. And we'll wrap it up here. Spartanburg County will feature Uncle Buck's Fishbowl and Grill. The new Spartanburg County Bass Pro Shops Outdoor World will feature a popular Uncle Buck's Fishbowl and Grill. This nautical themed center is located within the store and features a unique design and gear for family fun and dining. There will be 12 bowling lanes, offering customers a chance to feel like they're bowling under the ocean. Casual family dining will be available in the grill, where customers can dine on a variety of appetizers, sandwiches, salads, and burgers. That's just a tip. I mean, this is one of the most exciting announcements I think we can make in Spartanburg. This will be a day we'll all remember. And now, let me introduce you to Mike Donovan. Mike is Director of Retail. Thank you. It's a pretty happy day. You know, 12 years ago, I first met Johnny Morris. We worked together on a deal in Cincinnati, and he invited me to come and help him grow the company across America. And it's been a great time and a great thing. And on behalf of Johnny and everybody, all the associates at Bass Pro, we're very, very happy to be in this upstate part of South Carolina. It's fantastic market. It's full of hunters and fishermen and people who truly appreciate the outdoors and what we have here to serve all our recreational passions and desires. And we've been focused on this area for many years. It's a great place for hunting and fishing and camping in the outdoors. And I never really could find a perfect location. And John always said, things come with time. And thanks to the Packlet Milken folks and John Montgomery, and they've been really great to work with. We found 75 acres right in what I hope is a bullseye of this whole region. And we're going to put something together real special, real big, real different, and make this store super unique. The bowling alley is pretty cool.
Fishbowl.
Not a picture of it up here, but it should be a great thing. But the project is going to include not only our store, but a lot of other outdoor activities and archery and maybe some ranges and hotels. And it's all kind of a result of some of the programs that the state has put together to encourage new business. And we're very thankful to Governor Haley and her team and the folks at PRT who have helped to help put this project together as well. But most importantly, once I drove by that site for about the 50th time, and I saw the building that was there, the former mill was gone, and I realized how beautiful a piece of property it was. And I called up David, and I asked him if he would work with us to put this deal together. And truthfully, I've never really come across any county group council that has been so willing and open to work with us, and they've done a lot of great things to help put this deal together. So my hat's off to you guys for everything you've done. I love to see all the smiles when he started talking about the hunting and fishing. I saw people smiling, and I hope that that's what they were excited about, because it's very exciting for us to be here. And I don't know what else to do except for let's see how fast we can build this thing and get it open and have a lot of people happy. Thank you. I've got to tell you a funny story. The first time Mike came to visit with me in my office, I had no idea it was Bass Pro Shops. He had his logo covered up. We should give thanks to Bernie Maybank, too, your lawyer. He's smart. He knows how to do it. But Bernie Maybank called me and said that there was an economic development opportunity that he wanted to meet with me about. Could I meet with him? I said, absolutely. He said, when can you do it? I said, you tell me when you want to meet. And again, I didn't know who it was. It was a Burger King. We'll meet. We'll do whatever. He said, well, can we be in your office tomorrow afternoon? I said, sure. I'll change my schedule around. So Mike came in, and I've known Bernie Maybank, former director of revenue, for a long time. Mike came in and looked at my office. I've got a stuffed beaver, I've got a raccoon, a pheasant, I just moved my Bobcat out. And by the way, these aren't things that I shot. These are actually road kills that I've had stopped. People will call me and say, hey, David, I got an armadillo down here. That's what I want. But Mike, when he walked in and saw in an alligator, I have an alligator at home, stuffed alligator, he said, I think I'm going to like this guy. And then when I found out who he was with, I said, I think I'm going to like you too. But what's funny, Mike left. We spent a couple hours together that night. And we called a quick meeting the next morning. I got a couple of key council members together on my committee and got the chairman. I didn't let him tell about who it was. I said, I don't want him to know. I want you to play a video. All four of us stood up and applauded when he started that video. When he left, I realized I had an extra pair of sunglasses in my office. So I called Mike up. I said, you left your sunglasses in my office. I'll send them to you. This is last October, I think. He said, no, I just keep them. I'll be down there soon, and you know, don't mail them to me. So I didn't. Well, the next time he came, Carter Smith and I had dinner with him. We picked him up at the airport. I picked him up at the airport, downtown airport, and thanks for the nice facility there. Picked him up, and we went to Cribb's Kitchen for dinner. So I gave Mike his glasses. I said, Mike, here are your glasses. And they, oh, thank you, David, appreciate it. And when I took him back to the airport, I was going right by the beacon, going home. Mike called me. I thought, oh, the weather, it was terrible weather that day. Wind blowing 40, 50 miles an hour. I thought, oh, they're going to have to spend the night, which is not bad. We'd love to have them. But he said, David, I can't find my sunglasses. I said, I gave them to you when you got out of the airport. He said, I know. He said, they left them at the restaurant. I said, hang on a second. So I felt the back seat where they were, and I said, I got them. These sunglasses, I said, you're not getting them until we make the announcement. I asked Mike first, I said, where do we put them? He said, put them on the raccoon. So they put them on the raccoon in my office since October of last year. So Mike, here are your glasses. To wrap this up, I want to let Mike know that I am your first employee, non-paid, as you've got six others right here, along actually with all the county staff, all these people in this room, and all the other people in Spartanburg and the upstate. We're here to serve you. Like I said, we don't want this baby just to be born today. We're going to make Mike Dunham the smartest man in Bass Pro for picking this site and working with us. Thank you, Mike. Back over by Chris Jennings at the CBB table, and thank you, Chris, for bringing the water and the koozies and all. We got the press releases for y'all there. Also, if we got a group of people that we want to come up front. Carter Smith has a name of them. We got some Bass Pro Shop hats. We're going to do a little NASCAR type thing. All right. Yeah, Mike had mentioned getting Tony Stewart here, but unfortunately they're on vacation this week. But so we're going to do a little photo op right up front.
Hey, we'll get him here for the opening.
Yeah, we'll do it. Thank you all for coming. We appreciate it. Have a great day. God bless.